What's going down? This is Bambata with YK1K, the CEO. I'm sitting down with Fresh Talks. We're going to keep it 1,000 on the mic.
Yes, sir. I mean, I appreciate you coming through, my guy. Poking on gas, 3-5 in the blunt. Popping new tags, it's 1-over-1. I got them chopsticks, ain't going to lunch. Came out the creek, had to jump off a ton. Made off the streets, I came up from a crumb. 2,000 just for the shoes I put on. All right, bro. So, man, let's get right into it, bro. So, just tell me about the YK brand, man.
YK1K, Young Kings 1000, started about 2012, Tennessee State University. I'm from Dallas. It's a struggle, bro, you know. But it's more military than fashion, man. I love it.
Yeah. So you say it started out in Tennessee?
Yeah, I started at Tennessee State.
Oh, okay, okay.
My sophomore year.
Okay.
Been going ever since.
That's dope, bro. So what YK stand for? Tell me the meaning behind it.
YK, Young Kings.
Yeah.
1K, 1,000.
1,000 from the trenches, man. Straight out the trenches. Yes, sir. All right, bro. So, your brand, bro, it's really been making a lot of noise, man. Like, I'm seeing everybody in it random. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm even starting to see, like, NBA players in your brand, bro. So, man, just tell me, like, you know, how was that upbringing in your brand? Like, how it just really get off the ground?
Man, it took time, a lot of time, bro. Like, I've been doing this since 2012, so almost 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
We've been doing this about 10 years, and, you know, kind of the last 3-4 years, it kind of start bubbling and picking up. So, I always say no struggle, no progress, you know what I'm saying? So, trials and tribulations, wins and losses. But, you know, we still got a lot of work to do, so we're going to stay humble and we're going to keep going.
Yeah. So, like, how long you been doing it?
Since 2012.
So, what year is when it really just, like, you know, who was that big person that you seen rock your brand?
Man, our first big name to rock the brand was Kodak Black.
Oh, okay.
That was in, like, 2016.
Yeah,
we made Kodak Black a custom bomber jacket. I flew to Miami. I didn't have no plans on meeting him. I just know I made a custom bomber jacket for Kodak Black.
Yeah, how it look?
It was all orange.
Yeah.
It was all orange, bro. It was just perfect timing. Like, I pulled up. The day I pulled up, it so happened he was having a photo shoot for his brand, Sniper Gang, before it got popping.
Yeah.
So I pulled up with this custom bomber jacket. He must have canceled his whole photo shoot. And put my bomber jacket on and start having a photo shoot of my bomber jacket.
What?
It was crazy. It was crazy. But that's when I knew I had something special. Like,
yeah.
I walked in a room with Kodak and his whole demeanor changed.
Yeah. What you mean? Like,
he was... Like, bro, I walked in with some, I walked in kind of fly. You know, I had on some designer shoes, stuff like that. Like, I made Kodak go change clothes.
Yeah.
He seen me walk in with the YK on, looking fly. He must have went in his room and started showing shoes to his partners, like, bro, should I wear these?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So at that moment, I'm like, this is big time, you know, rapper. But, you know, this YK putting pressure on him. So at that point, I'm like, it's time, you know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
But he took the jacket, he wore it multiple times, took some good pics, and that's how stuff kind of started going up.
Okay. Yeah. So how you get, like, I seen, like, a clip on your page with the Baltimore Ravens.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? Like, how did it come about?
Man, just like with me and you, bro, relationships. I tell people all the time, it ain't about money. It's about the relationships you have with people. So one of my good brothers, Anthony Levine, I went to college with him.
Mm-hmm.
He's actually way older than me. I met him after he graduated in the training room, stuff like that. But just relationships, bro.
Yeah.
Just good relationships and people being good people.
Yeah.
You can't make that.
That's big, though. You know what I'm saying? That's major.
It was big. Like, and the crazy thing about it, like, they lost the game that they threw the jackets to.
Uh-huh.
But it was, like, almost good that they lost.
Why is that?
Because the way they showed up, they all had on, like, a Halloween mask with the windbreakers on.
Mm.
So it was, like, just extra promo.
Yeah.
Like, they was trolling them on ESPN how, oh, these guys wearing masks. And they went into the first round and lost.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But that was huge, though. That was huge, yeah.
Man, that's dope, bro. So I want to get into like the different, like the shorts. Like, how you get into like like, you know, the high schools, middle school, colleges? Like, what made you get into like, you know, excuse me, like support their brand? You know what I'm saying? Like,
man, bro. So
not their brand, but like their names. You know what I'm saying? Just
so in 2017, me and my little brother flew to China.
Yeah,
this was a life changing moment for both of us. We flew to China, didn't know anybody, kind of just exploring, trying to find a plug. Mm-hmm. Like, you know how people fly to Cali to find a plug?
Yeah.
We flew to China to find a plug for clothes, a manufacturer. Didn't know nobody, anything. So when we went to China, bro, we discovered where everything was made at. So at that point, it was no turning back. I'm looking at life like, everything I wear, I'm finna make it.
Yeah.
Everything. I'm not gonna buy no more designer shoes. I seen the real price.
Yeah,
I went to the Mason Margiela factory and seen them make these shoes for nothing.
That's crazy.
It messed my head up. Like, I used to spend $900 on Mason Margiela's. When I went to China, never again. You know what I'm saying? So when I left China, I had the mindset that, okay, bet, I'm finna make everything. So the basketball shorts, man, it's pretty simple. They're pretty trendy. They're just done. Mitchell and Ness, they were all doing like these different NBA shorts, stuff like that. So I'm like, I never seen no high school basketball shorts.
Yeah.
I never seen none. Like, and I made some Carter Cowboys shorts.
Those was the first one, the Carter Cowboys shorts?
Yeah, and the crazy thing is, I made them so wrong, bro. Like, they was, like, long, the wrong color blue, everything. And, like, people bought them, bro. They sold out in, like, I want to say, like, an hour.
That's the crazy. Wrong color. So, you feel like Carter's, like, the most, like,
man,
popular school that sell up.
I'm gonna tell you a crazy story. So all my customers come in the shop, I always have conversations with, especially the elders.
Mm-hmm.
And a cat told me, he told me, man, he said, I went to Cedar Hill, but when back in the day, everybody looked at Carter for the swag.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Carter was trendsetters back in the day. I didn't know that. Cause you know what I'm saying, I went to Carter and stuff like that, but they was like, we went to Cedar Hill, Carter was rocking the leather hats, leather shorts.
Yeah.
We looked at Carter for trends. Like, Carter was the fashion trend high school at Dallas.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, Carter's a huge supporter, man. Like I told you before the interview, I can't keep no Carter shorts, man. Shout out to the Carter alumni. Shout out to the high school. You know what I'm saying? All that. So, thank you.
Yeah. Nah, for sure, bro. Like, I start seeing, like, the Soto, Lincoln, you know what I'm saying? I just bought, what was it, the Atwell jersey? Like,
Atwell jersey.
Yeah, bro. That was like a one-on-one.
Yeah, it was. I mean, that's the thing with me, man. I try to do stuff I never seen before.
Yeah.
Like, you'll never see an Atwell Archer jersey for sale, ever.
Nah, I don't never see them jerseys for sale. Not no middle school jersey.
Not no middle school jersey. So, we hit them with the middle school shorts, the high school shorts, everything for the city, man. I just want to give the city something to be proud of.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, people love these shorts. It's like I created a monster.
Yeah. So how you feel when you did like a couple pop-up like shops?
Yeah, so the pop-up shop culture is crazy. Like, I've been doing pop-ups for a long time. Now you see everybody doing pop-ups.
Yeah, a lot of people.
Pop-ups is a trend. It's a trend to have a pop-up shop. Everybody's having a pop-up shop. Even having a clothing line right now is a trend. Nothing's wrong with it. That's great.
Yeah.
I love to see that type of trend because it teaches self, you know what I'm saying, economics. It shows people want to make their own money. So some trends are good.
Yeah.
So trends like having your own brand, let's keep that going. Everybody should have their own brand. Everybody should have some type of way to brand themselves.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, the pop-up shops, they're great. We had some pretty big pop-up shops. Shout out to the people. They a lot of work, though.
Yeah.
They hard work, but it's worth it, though, just meeting your people face-to-face. Like, it's one thing talking to people on the internet, having people buy stuff online, but just seeing, like, fresh face-to-face, like, hey, bro, how you doing?
Yeah.
How you been? You know what I'm saying? Having that personal connection with your customers means more than the money.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes pop-up, I don't even want no more money, like, I really just be like, hey, y'all got it. Y'all done show so much love. I don't want to take no more money after this certain time.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I really appreciate the people, man. They really keep me going, and they got us where we at right now.
Yeah. So, man, I want to touch on something like these designer stores, like Gucci, Mm-hmm. Burberry, like, and Louis, like, you know, like Louis, like, they don't really like show love to like the black community, you know what I'm saying? Because, and reason why I say that, like, this where they get their clientele from, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, how you feel about that?
It's called exploitation, capitalism, you know what I'm saying? Take advantage of the poor people, the working class people, these big companies take advantage of these little people. That's how America runs. So, I'm not surprised, you know, I'm not mad at these big designer brands. That's the system we live in, where you, the big people take advantage of the little people.
Yeah.
And us as a people, we gotta wake up. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm watching the decline of designer. Like, I'm watching these cats who used to buy all this Gucci get away from it. Because when a cat come around looking like this, with all this YK on, they confidence dropped, bro. Like, I'd have been in the club, bro, side by side from a cat wearing some designer.
Yeah.
I'm standing on top of the couch too. Like, I'm like this. You know what I'm saying? I'm vibing. I done watched the cat take off his whole outfit, bro, because he seen what I had on. You know what I'm saying? So the confidence in designer is dropping. It's at a decline right now, bro. So y'all go shop with y'all people, man, because we on the rise.
Yeah. Nah, for sure.
And another thing too, when COVID happened, all this looting was happening, you had old Johnny off the block wearing Gucci. He breaking in Gucci, taking Gucci. So at the same time, it's like the value's going down, bro.
Yeah. How you feel when they had that little controversy with, what was it, the blackface design they had going on?
It's typical, bro. It's controversy. They did that just to basically slap in the face.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Basically, like, hey, we're going to spit on you. You still going to buy our clothes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's no respect.
Yeah, nah, that's crazy. All right, man, I want to get into the shoes, bro. So this like the first season of the YK shoes, right?
Man, this is my first shoe ever.
Yeah.
My first shoe ever, man. My goal.
Yeah, take it out. Look, let's show it on the camera, bro.
My goal for the summer, bro, me and my team, we said we're going to troll designer brands this summer.
Yeah.
We're going to, like, try to ruffle their feathers. We're going to get in their heads. You know what I'm saying? I could have dropped the Air Force One, like, the Air Jordan One, like everybody's doing.
Yeah.
That's typical, though. I said, I'm going to do a designer shoe. And having the resources I have,
yeah,
I had to. So I reached out to the factory that make the same Dior shoe. The same factory that make Dior to ship them. They say made in Italy.
Yeah.
In China. You know what I'm saying? No shoe is made in China. Shoe is made in Italy, bro.
Yeah.
No such thing is made in Italy. It's all a lie. So these designer brands are lying to everybody, bro. It's the biggest lie in history.
And what are they saying?
They're saying made in Italy, bro. Like,
nah, with the designer brands, I mean, like what are you hearing? Like, what they saying?
Basically, like, the shoes that are in Neiman Marcus, the shoes that are in all these high-end stores, they're not made in Italy. You can't pay nobody in Italy to sit down and make shoes. There's no way possible.
Yeah.
It's no way possible, bro.
What Sauce Walker say? The Dior Strores. Nah, don't fire though, bro.
Yeah, our goal for the summer was just to troll these designer brands and wake our people up. It's a chess move. Let people know, like, hey, the same quality gonna come from somebody that just like you.
These hard though. I'm rocking with them, bro, for sure. How the sales going on these?
Oh, amazing. Shout out to the people that's copping.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to people who gonna cop. You know what I'm saying? Shop people ain't copping because they helping us out.
Right. What's the different colorways you have?
Man, so I dropped a black, a white and red, an all white and blue, and a white and pink.
Yeah.
We're going to keep it going, man. Like I said, it's no better feeling than, like, the day before, like, I started selling shoes, bro, I doubted myself. I'm like, people ain't going to like this shoe.
Yeah.
People going to, like, talk about it, going to laugh about it. And I took a deep breath and I'm like, oh, well.
That's crazy.
Man, like, ain't no redos in this thing we call life. Like, you got to go through it.
Got to. Nah, for sure. No cap.
You control the narrative. Like, you know what I'm saying? Your mind is everything. So, I went out there, you know what I'm saying, and got a victory. But like I said, shout out to everybody that supports the movement, man. We're going to keep it going just for y'all. Like, I go out, I see people wearing these shoes, and that messes me up. Like, I'm like,
thinking they some Dior's. Yeah.
Some Dior's.
Yeah.
And those cats who going out buying Dior's, nothing against them. But it's like, bro, this the same shoe. It's nothing different other than the name. So you telling me you'd rather buy some shoe from a white man named Dior than a black brother named Bambata?
Yeah.
I'll help you out. If you hungry, bro, let's go eat. You tell Dior you hungry, he gonna You can't talk to Dior.
You can't get to him. Too many security around him. No, sir.
Y'all white man. Grandkids right now, like.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm going to the schools. I'm giving back. I go feed the whole school Chick-fil-A.
Yeah.
The whole football team Chick-fil-A. Like, everybody eats in my community, bro.
That's dope, bro. So, man, you went to Africa, right?
I went to Africa.
When was that, like, last year?
It was my birthday, April 29th.
Yeah, you was out there. I think you passed out a lot of, you know product out Africa there.
For, like, 4 days. And my whole thing was just to give back. Like, that's not enough time to be in Africa to do anything. I was there for 4 days, and it's, like, just being around my people.
Yeah, what was the energy like out there?
I was unmatched. It's nothing like touching that soil. Being in the motherland, like, I tell people all the time, like, this is not where we from. It's a whole different energy just being on that, close to that equator, you know what I'm saying, on that land. Like, we are definitely, you know what I'm saying, great people. We come from greatness, bro. We come from greatness, and we shouldn't settle for less. Just knowing where we came from, so that energy is unmatched.
Yeah. Man, what was their reaction like when they were seeing all them clothes and stuff like that?
I must have walked up with a bag. Like, mind you, this is like Dallas. This is like little. I had some shorts, but actually some shorts that was like imperfected, like wrong color. They were perfect shorts, brand new.
Yeah.
Like maybe in the wrong color. They might have been some Carter shorts with yellow on it. Just some weird stuff. You know what I'm saying? So, bro, I'm giving out Dallas ISD basketball shorts in Ghana. They were gone in 30 seconds. Like, damn. I almost feel like I got robbed. It's the first time I ever got robbed. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, these cats must be. I'm like.
I seen somebody with some Carter shorts run down. I'm like, what was that right there? What?
Bro, cats like the size 5 feet tall grabbing 3Xs.
Yeah, that's crazy.
They putting them on, bro. And they threw me off. I'm like. That's crazy, bro. Like, don't take nothing for granted.
Yeah, nah, for sure. I seen that, bro. That was dope. Mm-hmm. Man, so how you feel about the other brands in Dallas? You know what I'm saying? Like Hidalgo, you know.
I said in my last interview, bro, like, the city is lit. Like, it's so many dope brands in the city right now. It's like, nobody should go to the mall. It shouldn't be nobody shopping at North Park Mall. We should boycott that shit.
Yeah.
It's too many dope brands in the city, bro, right now. It makes no sense to go to the mall and waste your money. Why not go support your brother? You know what I'm saying? Your sister. You know what I'm saying? It makes no sense. Like, it should be nobody black, African American, anybody of color.
When the last time you bought you something? Every time I see you in YK.
Bro, I haven't been to the mall in 7 years. Damn, that's I haven't been crazy. To the mall in 7 years. Like, even when I buy shoes, I might go to like DTLR or something. Like, you'll never catch me in the mall.
Yeah, that's crazy.
There's nothing in there for me, bro. Like, if I go to the mall, I might go and see what I can make, but it's like, for what? And the malls, even the malls are on the downfall. Like, COVID showed us that.
Yeah.
I give the malls another 20 years. Like, technology, online shopping, the malls might have another 10 years. Nobody's going to the mall, bro. Like, it's on the downside.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Man, so let's get into, like, the Pan-African stuff, bro. Like, let's get into your store. So how did it come about?
My parents, Bandeli Tahemba, Kwete Tahemba, and that's what I tell a lot of people. Like, I grew up in the business. Like, I didn't just start this clothing line at my apartment or, you know, on my own. I came up from, like, born, and I was raised in the business. I saw my daddy selling clothes when I was one. You know what I'm saying? He's selling people dashikis.
Yeah.
I'm seeing my mama selling, you know, jewelry. So I have a solid foundation that I came from. It kind of influenced me to do what I do now. So I owe the Pan-African everything.
Yeah.
Because I thought I was going to play football. I thought I was going to be an athlete. You know what I'm saying? Whole time, my whole life, unconsciously, I've been trained to be a businessman.
Yeah.
So, yeah, the Pan-African connection, 32 years going strong. We're going to keep it going for another 1,000 years.
That started being like 32 years, bro?
32 years, yeah.
Wow, that's dope.
It's been 32 years, man. It ain't been pretty, though. Like, my pops, he sacrificed himself for the business. He's not here no more. He passed away like 9 years ago. But he basically sacrificed himself for us and for the business. And that's what people got to understand. When you got a brand, you got a business, you got to put your all into it. Like, it's bigger than just your life. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's about your kids. It ain't just about Fresh right now. This interview ain't just about you. It ain't about me. This is about the generation that's come after us, bro. We have to pass the baton, pass the mic. You know what I'm saying? It's deep. You feel me? So when you start a business, you start in a brand, I always realize it's not about you. It's about the longevity in the next generation. Like, even right now, I be wanting to quit selling clothes, bro.
Really?
It should get depressing. Yeah, it gets depressing.
Man, I see so many people like, you know, Master P sons, they in the YK. Mm-hmm. Who else we seeing? You know, I'm seeing NBA players. They walking through. All you see is YK on. Mm-hmm. If it's a bag, you know what I mean? Just, I see it.
Right.
Like, outside of Dallas, you know what I'm saying? That, I'm sure they probably, like, keep you going. Like, times you want to give up. Next thing you know, you see somebody big.
Like, yeah, it'd be nice. I want to give up. And I wake up the next morning, trailblazer. Wearing YK1K.
Yeah.
And that just keep me going, you know what I'm saying? So, even the strongest of, like, people looking like, man, why you work so hard?
Didn't LeBron sound, like, what was that, Bryce?
I should LeBron to,
Brunny.
He probably caught it, but he ain't wear it, you know?
Oh, okay, okay.
Hey, I know you got that pack. Y'all need you to put it on, you feel me? So, hey, I
no cap. Nah, for sure.
We gonna touch King James. It's already manifested. Jay-Z, King James, Cole. It's on the way there. They done seen it. Trust me, they done seen the YK.
Yeah.
They ain't blind. So, we just gonna keep working.
Yeah, that's dope, bro. So, what's next? What's next you got cooking up?
Like, we working with a lot of college athletes, man. Shout out to everybody just signed with the YK1K Athletics. We're gonna take over the college industry for sure.
Okay, tell me about that.
It all started from the college shorts.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like I told you, we was doing the college shorts under the table, you know what I'm saying? And they called me.
What school reached out and like, hey, what's going on? Like,
oh, they somebody snitched on me.
Yeah.
I got snitched on, and I found out who snitched on me. The crazy thing is, AD at some school snitched on me, and he eventually called me. We met face to face.
Yeah.
He told me, like, hey, man, I'm a brother who snitched on you. I'm like, okay, cool, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, I was blessed for him, you know what I'm saying, to reach out to him. Like I said, let's make this a bigger and better thing. Like, let's make this huge. Let's blow up HBCUs.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's all business, you know what I'm saying? We handle it like businessmen. It ain't personal. But, you know what I'm saying, when you're on a certain level, man, they're going to come after you.
Yeah.
They want some of that. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
They want a piece of that. So, shout out to all the HBCUs, all the athletes. We're going to take it to a whole nother level.
Yeah. You going to make a kid brand? Like, you know.
I have to.
I
have to make a kid line. I was just talking to one of my comrades the other day about it, so it's on the way.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's dope, bro.
I mean, what type of brand would be called Young Kings if we didn't have no kids clothes? You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's like,
come on. Gotta make it for the youth.
I ain't young. I'm 28. I ain't young no more. I ain't Young King no more. You know?
Yeah. Man, we all Young Kings out here in these streets, man. No cap, man. Hey, bro. Any shout outs you want to give, bro, before we get up out of here?
Man, I just want to say shout out to the ancestors, shout out to all the KBs, shout out to everybody that supports, not just me, but everybody in the city.
Yeah.
Shout out to the city of Dallas, man. Shout out to Billy Gang. You know what I'm saying? Like, Billy Gang was one of my, I looked up to Billy Gang, like, oh, y'all, you, Elijah, David, everybody, like, I looked up to y'all, bro, in high school. Y'all didn't know it.
Yeah.
I was, like, influential. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, for sure, man, for sure.
Man, huge shout out to Billy Gang. Y'all inspired me to make clothes. Like, I think David had a brand. What was it, Billy Express?
Yeah, he got the shout out David Impey, man, with the Billy Express, for sure.
David Impey, man. I remember Billy Express, bro. He dropped, like, a T with, like, a torpedo on it a long time ago. To y'all, man, a lot of stuff, you know. I just want to give credit to everybody who helped me get to where I'm at. But we're going to keep it going. It ain't going to stop.
Yeah, ain't no competition out here, man. You know, no, Young Kings, I man.
Ruffle the feathers of these Fortune 500 companies than my own comrades in the city. Like, I wish we could all come together and drop a big old collection, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like a Dallas collection, like, every...
Like Rudy's, Williams, right. Goddamn, that'd be whole, I could say.
Whole Dallas collection, and let's go to war with everybody else. Let's go to war with Houston, let's go to war with L.A. I bet we win.
Yeah.
Like, I bet we win, bro, because we got the fire.
Yeah. That's what's up. Hey, man.
It costs money to go to war, too. So if any other cities want to do that, let me know. It costs money to go to war. Let me know.
Yeah. Hey, man. You definitely got me dripped down with the YK, man.
You
for
got
sure.
Yourself dripped down, bro. Look at you. I can't make this up, bro.
Yeah.
You put two and two together. I don't know.
Appreciate that. Hey, man. I looked at the colors. I'm like, yeah.
Bro, got an eye. That's why they call you fresh.
Yeah, for sure. Fresh.
You always been fresh, though, bro. Like, you always been fly.
Appreciate it, bro.
I remember, bro. Trust me, I got a good memory.
Man, Edwear days, man, I was, no. Oh, no. Man, I wore like a purple hoodie every day. Nappy and fro.
Y'all like
that, though. Oh, God. I had a day, you know, a couple of days. All right, man, let them people know where they can follow you. You know, where they can follow the brand. Let them know where they can, you know, shop it. You know what I'm saying?
Young Kings Clothing on Instagram, YK1K.com online.
Yeah.
At the Pan African Connection, we there pretty much every day. It's Tuesday through Sunday, so pull up.
Dope, dope. All right, man. Y'all now tuned into Fresh Talks. We up out of here. Yes, sir.